In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, Father, we thank you because your word is evergreen and is always light, lamp unto our feet and light unto our path. Lord, we thank you for the life and inspiration we draw from your word from time to time. We bless your name forevermore. We thank you because your word keeps us on track. We thank you because your word is our means of livelihood and sustenance. Glory to your name forevermore. Blessed be your name. We become a shining light to our generation, and we become like the stars forevermore through the impartation of your word. Glory to your name in the mighty name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. Hallelujah. The title of our message today, A Season of Healing Continued. A Season of Healing Part 2. And our text is taken from Malachi chapter 4, from verse 1 to 3, just as we had it last week. But I would like to read verse 2. But unto you that fear my name shall the Son of Righteousness arise with healing in his wings. But unto you that fear my name shall the Son of Righteousness arise with healing in his wings. The word fear here, like we said last week, refers to honor, to fear the name of the Lord is to honor the name of the Lord, to believe in, to revere, and to hold in high esteem the name of the Lord. And I would also like to say here that to honor the Lord is to honor his name. Of course, if you honor somebody's name, it's because of the honor that you bestow upon that person. So those who honor the Lord honor his name. Hallelujah. It also implies that you believe or you put your absolute trust in him, and consequently in his name, just like I said earlier. In John chapter 1 verse 12, the Bible says, but as many as received him, to them he gave power to become children of God, or sons of God, even to them that believe in his name, as many as received him, he gave them power. So the power to become the sons of God, the power to become children of God, is given to them that believe in his name. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. In Malachi chapter 3, about 3 verses away from our anchor text, Malachi 3 verse 16 to 18, Bible says, then they that feared the Lord spoke often. They that feared the Lord, or those who feared the Lord, spoke to one another, and the Lord listened to them and heard them. Those who feared the Lord, they spoke, that is, they declared to one another. And I want to ask you, at this time, at such a time as this, what are you saying? What are you speaking? What are you declaring to yourself, to your family, to your friends, to people around you, to the situation around you? You know, so many people are saying a lot of things. What are you saying? What are you declaring? What are those things that that feared the Lord spoke to one another? So what are you speaking? What are you declaring? Are you declaring the word of faith? Are you declaring the word of assurance to the people around you? You know, because what you declare is a function of what you believe. And what you believe in is a function of who you honor. They that honor the name of the Lord, they declared. They that fear the Lord, they that honor the Lord, they declared to one another. And Bible said, the Lord listened to them. You know, the King James Version says, the Lord hearkened them. The Lord hearkened. That is, he listened and he heard it. So many people are declaring, but the Lord is not hearing. And the Lord is not paying attention to them, because they are just declaring vain and empty words. But they that declared unto one another through the fear of God, because, you know, the fear of God is a determinant of what you declare. Hallelujah. So he said the Lord heard it, and a book of remembrance was written before him for them that feared the Lord. A book of remembrance was written before the Lord for those who fear the Lord and thought upon, that is, those who meditate on his name. They thought upon his name, they ponder on his name, they meditate upon his name, they honor his name, they esteem the name of the Lord. Do you honor the name of the Lord? Are you like many people who believe that they should explore every possible avenue and eventually fall back on prayer as a last resort? Or you honor the name of the Lord? If you honor the name of the Lord, you will know that there is no alternative to prayer. There is no alternative to calling upon the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. To fear the name of the Lord is to acknowledge that absolute power lies therein, to break every chain, to loose, to bind, to heal, to deliver, and even to subdue situations around you, and even nations and kingdoms. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. And in verse 17 and 18, he said, they shall be mine. The Lord said, they shall be mine. He said, they shall be mine, saith the Lord. That is, the Lord said, they shall be his chosen and peculiar treasure. At this time of pandemic, the Lord says you are his. You are his chosen treasure. You are his peculiar treasure. He has hidden you under the shadow of his wings. So no shaking. You cannot be afraid of the terror by night or the arrow that fly in the noonday. He said you are his chosen treasure, jewel of inestimable value. He said he will spare you in the time of tribulation, affliction, and adversity. So many things will happen after this, but the Lord said you are covered in him, you are secured in him. As long as you fear the name of the Lord and you put your hope in him and in his name, he said, then shall you return and discern between the righteous and the wicked, between those who serve God and those that serve him not. So this is the time of discernment, discerning between the righteous and the wicked, those who honor the name of the Lord, who serve him, those who serve his purpose. He spares them, he keeps them, even for such a time as this and thereafter. Because it takes a true son. He said he will spare them as a father, as a man spares his own son that serves him. So it takes a true son to serve the father's purpose without holding back. The servant of God they that serve the Lord, they shall shine forth as the brightness of the firmament. Now is the time for the sons of the kingdom to shine, to arise and shine in the midst of darkness, in the midst of the pandemic, in the midst of conflict, in the midst of whatever is happening around the globe. Now is the time for deliverers to spring out from Zion to begin to profess solution to world problems. I declare to you, arise and shine. The Son of Righteousness rises upon you with healing in his wings. And as you go forth, you will grow up in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. The glory of the Lord is upon you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Before I close, I quickly want to share with us the prophetic declaration, or what I call the testimony of a young man called David concerning the name of the Lord. In 1 Samuel chapter 17 verse 45, the Bible said David told Goliath, he said, look, you come to me after Goliath had said some occultic words concerning David. And David replied to him, he said to the Philistine, you come to me with a sword and with a spear and with a shield, but I come to you in the name of the Lord of hosts, the God of the armies of Israel, whom you have defiled. The name of the Lord of hosts, the God of the armies of Israel. So David declared boldly, he made a prophetic, and thereafter, you can read it, all what David said thereafter was a prophetic statement. It was prophetic. Why? Because the testimony of Jesus is the spirit of prophecy. Everything he said, he didn't have a sword, but he said, I'm going to cut off your head to the Philistine. Why? Because he had one underlining instrument of warfare, the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. And lastly, before I draw this to a close, Psalm 20 verses 7 and 8. The Bible says, some trust. I believe David said this is the Psalm of David. Maybe he recalled to some of the battles he had, particularly that of Goliath. He said, some trust in chariots. He knew what it was like putting on the chariot, the chariot of Saul, and he was like, look, this doesn't just fit. This doesn't fit in. And he said, I've not proven this, I've not tested it, but I got something that works for me. The name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous runs into it and is secure. He says, some trust in chariots and some in horses, but we will remember. We will latch on to the name of the Lord our God. And when they are brought down and are falling, because chariots will fail, horses will fall, they will be brought down, they will come crashing, they will fail. It's the Egyptian value system, Babylonian value system. It will crash. Whatever it is, that which is of the world, it can never have a long-lasting effect. It will crash. But that which comes from above is above all. He said, they are falling, but we are risen and we stand upright. For those who are trusting and those who honor and fear the name of the Lord, particularly in this season, you will stand, you will rise, you will stand upright, you will not fall. As you grow up, you will stay up in the name of Jesus Christ. I declare divine revelation, divine elevation, divine provision is your portion in the name of Jesus Christ. The Son of Righteousness will arise with healing in his wings and bring forth healing to you and to your family and to your generation. So shall it be in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. In the mighty name of the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. God bless you.